Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I am Owem Akpan. It is such a pleasure to have you stop by once more. So today I want to speak about three reasons you should not marry to become responsible. Or you could put it the other way too. Three reasons you should not believe the myth, marry to become responsible. I want to speak on this because many people incorrectly assume that when you get married, you become responsible, as if marriage is what makes people become responsible. Could feel like for single people who are not married yet, that they are irresponsible. Whatever they do with their lives, they don't have responsibility, which is a big lie. So these people who actually say this or believe this, then try to encourage single people to go get married so that they will become responsible, because they obviously think or believe that every single people out there will be wilding out, not responsible, doing anything anyhow. And they feel like, okay, if we trap you into marriage, maybe you will calm down, you chill. But that's not the right approach to it. If you want to hear more about this, keep watching. Point number one, marriage does not make anyone responsible. I will put it this way, you do not marry to become responsible, but you should become responsible to get married. Which is, before you want to consider marriage, you should be a responsible person. Let me just go back to the scripture a little bit. In Genesis, when God created man, God gave man work, and man was responsible. Adam was responsible before he was introduced to this relationship called marriage. Before God brought him a wife, God saw that Adam was responsible. God gave Adam work to do. He gave him animals to name, and Adam did it excellently. And God saw, now this guy can handle responsibilities. Let me give him something else to do. God brought a wife to him. When God brought a wife to Adam, he knew that Adam was responsible. So today, you cannot assume that getting married is what will make you responsible, because marriage is not to be blamed if you get there and then get disappointed. Because I think that's the mindset that makes a lot of people get into marriage and then feel disappointed, because they expected to get something from marriage, not knowing that if you do not take something there, you can't get anything there. I put it this way, marriage is like a vessel. What you put into it is what you get. Whether it's a cup, whatever you put, if you put water in a cup, you're gonna drink that. If you put milk or tea, make a tea, you're gonna drink that. It's also like a soil. Whatever you sow or plant, that's what you reap. So if you plant peace, you plant love, you plant loyalty, you plant transparency and vulnerability, if you plant trust, you are bound to reap that if it's done mutually in the context of marriage. But if you are not responsible and you hope to get into marriage to become responsible, then marriage is not to be blamed. I want you to know that being responsible or to become responsible, it is a choice that each person gets to make to be disciplined. It's a choice to become disciplined, which is to mature, to grow. Whichever area of your life you feel like you are losing, whether it's in your finances, it's in your passion and urges, like you can't control yourself, that's where you need help. You go get help to control yourself, learn self-control, discipline yourself in the areas you feel like you have weaknesses, because everybody sure have weaknesses in life, but marriage is not what cures the weakness that you have. If you have lust, you need to go get help. Don't expect to get into marriage to solve your lust, because it will not. Point number two, marriage adds responsibility to you. In as much as marriage does not make you responsible, it is another responsibility on its own. It adds responsibility to you, because at first you might have been responsible for just you, your dreams, your vision, and every other thing you had going on. But once you get married, you are expected to be responsible for your wife, and as a wife, responsible for your husband, which takes a lot of selflessness, because at that point you're no more just thinking about you. You're not selfish again. You're thinking about your partner, your spouse. In that aspect, you know that's a responsibility on its own, because if you are someone that loves privacy and you get into that place and then your privacy is messed with, come on, that's a responsibility that you've taken on, and you need to be ready for this. You need to be responsible to get there. You don't go there to become responsible, because once you go there and you see things that do not line up with what you like, you might want to fight, and then that is against the mutual connection relationship you have. Because if you start fighting each other, it's bound to break what you have. In order to not make such a mistake, this myth, marriage to become responsible, should not exist even at the back of your mind. Your being responsible is a choice to be disciplined. Because had it been marriage could cure irresponsibility, we would not have married people who still misbehave, cheat, disloyal, abuse, or whatsoever thing that is happening in the context of their home. We would not have any of that, because marriage would be the sanest place, like I just used that. It would be the most sane place to be in, and everybody would desire to get there. But in today's world, you can't say that, because you get to hear stories, you get to see things, or from when you grew up, if you want to say the truth and tell us the experiences you saw from your dad and your mom. For some, it was a little bit manageable. For some, it was something good. But for some, it was the worst case scenario. People shouldn't be deceived to get into marriage hoping to become responsible. Any person that is irresponsible being single will not change because of marriage, or marriage will not change that person. Marriage can only change your status from single to married, but it will not change your heart. Your heart is your choice to decide to work on growing, on changing. Being single does not mean you are irresponsible, and being married does not mean that you are most responsible. It just means that you have added responsibilities. So don't misconstrue it to think that being single means you have no responsibility at all. That's a big lie. In fact, most single people are the ones that even have more responsibilities than some married people. And I say that specifically, some married people do not have so much responsibility, because if both partners are working, it really helps them know how to channel their finances to what is right. But for a single person who's trying to build a dream and a purpose on his own or her own, it becomes really difficult. And they have so much at hand to take care of. As much as there's an added responsibility in marriage, there's also some convenience if it's done right. The responsibility that marriage adds is that you're no more selfish. That's a lot of responsibility. To not just think about just you. Go lie down, you know, do anything you want to do at your own time. But at this point, there are people that have come into your life, and you don't have to be absent-minded that they are there and want to do your thing. The third reason you should not get married to become responsible is marriage itself is work. W-O-R-K. Work. It's a lot of work to make it work. For a good marriage to exist, the couple has to work, because it's really not easy. You're coming from different backgrounds, you're coming from different places with different mindset, different upbringing. So the process of becoming one, or even trying to think alike, is really tough. And it takes tenacity, humility, honesty, transparency, every good thing that you can name. It takes all of that for each partner to really be able to get fused together. It's not just about sex. It's not just about sex, because you can have sex and wake up and still fight. And in order to limit, I'm not saying fight will be eliminated. So life generally, you will not always agree with someone 100%. So that is why it's not possible to eliminate fights. I'm not talking about abuse here, or any kind of fight that could be avoided, but out of stubbornness or ego or pride of one person or the other, then that exists. I'm not talking about such situation. I'm just talking about normal situation of, you know, you might not agree in some things. So those kind of things will not cease. But in order to even have a healthy marriage, is work. Marriage itself is work, which means a marriage is as good as the couple. A marriage is as good as the people involved. A marriage is as bad too as the people involved. A toxic marriage is because toxic people are involved in it. A good marriage is because good people with good hearts who wants to make things work are involved. An insecure marriage is a marriage where you have people who are insecure engaged together. So whatsoever your marriage is, check yourselves. I'm not trying to talk about that. I'm not trying to give marriage advice, but I'm just saying marriage itself is work. So before you get there, you have to be responsible. If you're not responsible, do not think to that area yet. Go learn. Don't say, when I get to that bridge, I will cross. No, start learning now as a single person. Start learning now. Start studying whatsoever you can study to get. Start studying. It's not just about, you know, sex or passion. It's not just those things. There are a lot of heavier, weightier relationship matters you need to learn. You need to know communication and all. You need to get into all of those things so that you can be ready and rich on the inside to have a good marriage. Because that's God's dream for every child of His, that you would marry right. Because marriage actually depicts relationship, vertical relationship where we have with Him, with Christ, who came, died, gave Himself for us, as Paul states in Ephesians. You don't have have to take it lightly. It is work itself. So don't let pressure lead you down. Do not let desperation lead you down, but let determination lead you down, which means you become responsible and you choose like, I'm ready for this next stage of life. I'm ready to take this responsibility. See it as something that I am ready to give. Not I am ready to go take something from someone. No, I'm ready to give something. I'm ready to sacrifice a part of me. Not in a bad sense. I'm ready to sacrifice. It could be my selfishness. I'm ready to sacrifice my pride. I'm ready to sacrifice my ego. I'm laying most things down. I'm growing. I'm maturing. I'm ready to become more patient. Then you get into this. That's what taking responsibility looks like. That's what being responsible looks like. Because Jesus even said in Luke, no man wants to build a tower and then do not count the cost. Because if you don't count the cost of the tower you want to build, you'll be scorned. You mock yourself. You make a mockery of yourself. Because at the end of the day, you won't be able to complete this tower. So he said, count the cost before you start it. Check your capacity, whether it's financial capacity or whatsoever capacity you have. Check it and know that you are responsible in all areas before you start this journey. It's a journey not to be joked with. It's a journey not to play about. It's a journey not to just go in with no thought. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you're blessed by it. I hope you've learned one or two things from it. Please do well to subscribe to this channel. Click the notification bell so that you can receive notifications on new videos that are gonna come up. Become a part of this community. Let me hear from you in the comment section. It will be such a joy of mine to see you there. Thank you so much. God bless you. Bye.